Basically, we all just want to spread Sensei's legacy and Sensei's name and take it forward and all her life, what she stood for, you know. So it just so happened that recently I was going to a trip to India and I wanted to explore what would it take to spread Sensei's message in India. And part of it is personal too, because growing up, I always wanted to learn martial arts and there was no opportunity. And I thought, hey, if I could provide that opportunity to like one kid growing up, the one that I didn't have, and that would be great. Not only did we have people in positions of power who can make this happen, just take up the program and just become on the spot, become sponsors and say, hey, yes, we want this. We want to empower our girls. Please come and train them. But every single demo that we did, I was surrounded by at least a mob of 15, 20 eager high school students to teenagers just saying, hey, when can we start training? So that level of enthusiasm and response is just amazing. And now it's like, oh, we need to fulfill our end of the deal and start the program right away because they're interested.
The foundation saw many of these articles and saw many things on TV about the abuse of women in India and about the poverty. And we feel, the foundation felt that it's time for us to do something. And this is our first major project of the Keiko Fukuda Foundation.
The time seems to be right, you know. India's ready for it, you know. Women's empowerment, that's the need of the hour, and very pleasant response, very, very positive. But even from a logistics point of view, things just couldn't have timed better. My old judo sensei, Mr. Sharma, who I think embodies Sensei's values and Sensei's motives and will help us carry it out, just so happens that he retired last year and is available and is going to run the program. And then, you know, there's this National Institute of Sports that's right there in my hometown. So I'm starting in a place where I can use my personal connections. Right. You know, we have a 501c3 set up here, but in India we don't have any infrastructure right now. So the whole idea is use personal connections, get the program going, and we want to be in every school, in every city in India so that every little girl has the option to learn martial arts and self-defense. But starting, so there's this town called Patiala. I'm from there in Punjab in India. North doesn't really have a very good track record in women's rights, so it's a perfect place to start. Everybody has been phenomenally supportive. So I ended up taking a bunch of volunteers, even up to 10 volunteers, doing demos in local high schools and local colleges. So all these judokas, you know, took time off from the, some of them had to call in, you know, we'll be coming in late to school or late to college, and they all were volunteering, and we went and did demos. It was amazing. And then the colleges, the you know, starting off right off the bat, Dr. Neelamjeet Kaur of the State College, she was not only receptive, she put me in touch with five other educational institutions and their heads. And she offered a space in her own college and said, hey, you can teach right here. We have the space for free. Just send us the teachers and we'll provide the girls and you can train and start taking it from there. So that's kind of where it started turning from, oh, I really want this to happen. It's a dream, to, oh my God, it's happening. It's right now. It's right here. And it's going to be much bigger than I had thought. You know, this is what happens when the timing's right and you find the right people. Big shout out to Ma'am Tarival, Ma'am Rosa, and Dr. Pasricha of Women's Girls College. So these are all the educational institutions that we gave demos at, and every single one of them ended up saying, I want it, I want the training program, and I want it now. When can you start? Here's the space, here's our time, we'll provide supervision, all the girls are at your disposal, PED, period, whatever you want to take over. Looking forward to the program taking off. We are actually thinking of starting in January, and hopefully by April we'll have a demo by the Indian students of Shihan Keiko Fukuda.